Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. I leave with a little queasiness. I leave with a little bit of trepidation, but I leave with confidence.
Paul Beeston has assumed a new presidency. He is stepping down as president of the Blue Jays into a newly created post, president of Major League Baseball, based in New York.
Well, it is a little bit different and a little bit foreboding in a lot of ways. But you know, it's been a long climb, I suppose, to the position that I'm in right now. I'm honored that I even had the position with the Blue Jays.
Beeston was the first employee hired by the Blue Jays and brought a business acumen to baseball many consider the most respected in the game. In tandem with GM Pat Gillick, Beeston built the fledgling franchise into a perennial and profitable baseball power. The pinnacle, of course, back-to-back World Series championships in 1992 and 1993.
Nobody's going to replace Paul Beeston. Somebody else will do the work. But Paul has made a tremendous contribution to this organization. He really has been the Blue Jays.
And as he leaves the Blue Jays' nest, Beeston leaves a legacy of success. 2 world titles, 2 league titles, 5 division titles. Not to mention the distinction as the first team in baseball history to bring over 4 million fans into the ballpark in one season. But that was 4 years ago, and Beeston knows baseball's counting on him as president to bring them back again. And now joining us, the man of the moment. And Paul, you talked about some trepidation in leaving the Blue Jays. What was your personal motivation in taking on this new challenge?
Well, it was time to move, and I couldn't move to another team, Rob. I mean, that was an impossibility. I mean, I believed myself as a Blue Jay, and there was no opportunity to go anywhere else in my mind that would have done anything that would have satisfied me, because I'd have been cheering for the Blue Jays. When this came available, and they thought that I could do the job and contribute to Major League Baseball, which has been very kind to me, to my family, it was something that I thought I might want to take a shot at. Kids are at university now, and you know, it's the right time, and hopefully I can do something that'll be good for the game.
It's the right time to do something good for the game. What do you think will be the priority for the president? What do you expect to do to put your stamp on this game?
Well, you know, it's too early to come up with an agenda that say it's going to have a stamp on it, but what I'd like to do is to build some relationships, number one, between the union, the players, and the ownership. I mean, they're all good people. The players are spectacular. The union is good to work with. I've got good relationships with the union, and the owners I really like. I mean, be one of those ones, if I ever walked away from the game, you know, strange enough, I'm going to miss the owners as much as I miss anybody. I mean, that's one of the things, and I'll be able to stay with them. If I can do that, I think international baseball will be good, and I think that if we can get the game built back to where it was in 1993 and 1994 prior to the strike and get that excitement there, I think that, you know, that this game has only got unlimited potential.
Mr. President, all the best in New York.
Bob, thanks very much.
Hey, thanks for joining us.
Okay, thank
all
you.
The best to you.
Okay.
Paul Beeston, the longtime president of the Toronto Blue Jays, and now the new president of Major League Baseball.